was the dead body found? Who found the dead body? Was the dead body dead when found? How was the dead body found? Who was the dead body? Who was the father or daughter, brother, mother? Uncle, sister, son, of a dead and abandoned body. Was the body dead when abandoned? Was the body abandoned? By whom had it been abandoned? Was the body naked or dressed for a journey?
Dressed for journey.
What made you declare the dead body dead? Did you declare the dead body dead? How well did you know the dead body? How did you know that that body was dead?
I didn't.
Did you wash the dead body?
No.
Did you close both its eyes?
Sure.
Did you bury the body? Did you leave it abandoned? dead body. Where was the dead body found? Who found the dead body? Was the dead body dead when found? Did you wash the dead body?
No.
Did you close both its eyes?
I didn't.
Did you bury the body?
No.
How well did you know the dead body?
I did.
Did you know the dead body?
I did.
Did you know the dead body?
I didn't.
Did you know the dead body?
Yes.
Margot.
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 Margot, what are you doing? What is that?
Hello?
Hey, Margot. Nothing. What are you doing? What are you doing? What is that?
I'm trying to sacrifice myself.
Ah. Well, okay. It's not really working.
No. She's trying to sacrifice herself, guys. Why?
It's impressive. It's different. It's, I don't know, the octopus dance, but it doesn't really work.
It's not working, man. Come on. Nobody believes you're sacrificing yourself. You're trying. I know it's difficult, but stop it. It's tiring.
What?
We don't really believe it.
Wait a minute. You're saying that I'm not doing my job properly? That I don't know how to die on stage?
Yes, that's what we are saying, yeah.
Yes,
Margot. Ça marche quoi? Enfin, it's not. Come on. It's difficult.
Wait, okay. You seem like you know very much about it. So, you know what? I'm gonna calm down, not take it personal, and learn from it.
That's very good. That's very kind of you. So, not take it personally. Okay, we're trying to sacrifice. It's not suicide, you know? You're there alone. Like
wait. Just take a look. You ready?
Yeah, she's been dying a lot. Yeah.
Perfect.
Thanks. That's working, no? I mean, we believe more.
Okay, do we all agree on that? Do you all agree with those guys?
Yes, we agree. Yes.
Monsieur is not so sure about it.
No, he agrees.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, but she was a lot practicing before.
Huh? Okay, we help. You need a friend. I can stab you. I can strangle you.
That's really kind from a friend. Yeah. Stab? No, it's not working. No, because there's no sword or something. But how represent sacrifice? Stop dying, please. You've been dying a lot. We need you. Okay. The music is really good. With the music or something. Can you help me to take that off? Actually, your friend does really well.
Thank you. Augen, ihrem Gesicht, in ihrem von steinernen Glanz, solche verliere ich nicht in einem Gefühl der Wärme. Sie mit uns, die Vorstellung.
Sie haben ein wunderschönes Kleid an. Es passt herrlich zu diesem schönen Sommertag.
Welch wunderbares Lächeln.
Sehr, das strahlt mich an wie die Morgensonne.
Die Blüte einer sanften Frühling im heiligen blauen Morgen. Sie haben so ein Glück mit ihrer Freundin. Sie sind auch ein sehr, sehr hübscher Mann.
Sie ausstrahlen, als würde ich sie so sehen.
Und ich mag ihren
Blick. So strahlend wie Sterne am Himmelszelt.
Welcome, everybody. Friends, we can welcome our guests. Welcome. Welcome to our farewell party for unlived experiences and fantasies. I say it also this side of the room. Yeah, everyone is comfortable. Yeah, you can use two pillows, put your feet on it. You can just feel comfortable, relax, enjoy. Like this man here is enjoying his sheep. Wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a farewell party for unlived experiences and fantasies. Welcome to the mountain. Yeah, I see some smiles in the audience. I like that because it makes me feel also smiling. I just want to explain this, where you are. What is our party? This is a farewell party for unlived experiences and fantasies. Just for a second, if you feel comfortable, just if you feel comfortable, of course, close your eyes. I'll ask you, yeah, just this woman doesn't feel comfortable, so keep your eyes open, no problem. But the other, you can close your eyes, yeah, and imagine. Imagine, ladies and gentlemen, you have only 2 months to live. You have only 2 months to live before being sacrificed. What would you do? It's a personal reflection. Just dig into yourself, your imagination. There might be a place you would love to go. There might be a person you would like to invite to this place. Where would you go? Who would you invite? What is your fantasy? What is the unlived experience you would finally be able to experience in this last 2 months of your life before your sacrifice? You can open your eyes. And I want to share my reflection, because during the rehearsal of the process I've been thinking about sacrifice and about what would I do if I had only 2 months to live. Well, the result of my research is that I would like to be an orchestra conductor. If I had only 2 months to live, I would go to New York Symphony Orchestra, enter the room and say, this is me, the conductor tonight. And I would love to feel, you know, this kind of, I don't know if it's a power, but there's something really special in the character of the orchestra conductor. I would like to stand on the podium with a choir of 200 people in front of me, an audience of 5,000 people, and I would enter the room, and the moment I enter the room, there's a big applause.
Oh yeah!
Wow. Thank you, thank you. You see, conductor, they have this. Actors, they never have this. This is wonderful. They enter, there's this big applause. But then after, I would love to stand on this podium, and I would do tick, 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 you know, this gesture, and there would be a silence. There would be a kind of a holy silence. You know, when the symphony is about to begin, there's a huge silence. Everybody stops moving. Everybody stops coughing or talking, whatever. There's something like a suspension of time just before the symphony. And I would be the one there, feeling this energy, raising my hand.
Wenn ich nur noch 2 Monate zu leben hätte, würde ich mir einen Kindheitstraum erfüllen.
Ist das nicht schön? Hast du sowas denn schon einmal gesehen? Glaubst du nicht auch, ich hätte viel schon erreicht? Sieh diesen Schatz, mein Lieblingsstück. Ich hab's gefunden, fand ich nicht mein Glück. Siehst du dich um, glaubst du wohl? Sie hat alles schon. Ich hab zahllosen Kram und viel Plunder. Ich ersticke im Klimbim. Zieh nur her. Willst du staunen? Hier. Kleine Wunder. Doch für mich reicht es nicht. Ich will mehr. Ich möchte fort bei den Menschen sein. Ich möchte fort dort mit ihnen tanzen. Möchte mich drehen und, wie heißt das Wort? Gehen. Dort ist man frei, dort ist man froh. Dort scheint das Licht der Mond. Anders als hier, drum will
Menschen,
ein Mensch zu sein. Mit Herz und Sinn zieht's mich dorthin, ich will's probieren. In meiner Hand, was man nur selbst spürt. Ich will's wissen, endlich wissen, ich bin gespannt. Und interessiert, was man oben weiß. Hab viele Fragen und möchte auf Antwort. Was ist Feuer? Und wie ist es, wie sagt man, heiß? Was ist der Preis? Ich sah ihn gern, wenn ich am Ziel, dort oben. Heute und hier.
Dankeschön. Super. Also, herzlich willkommen. Mein Name ist Moritz Ostruschniak. Einige von Ihnen kennen mich, einige nicht, die meisten wahrscheinlich nicht. Ich möchte Sie nochmal herzlich willkommen heißen, hier in unserer Fantasy Lounge. Ich hoffe, Sie haben sich's auch schön bequem gemacht. Ja, sehr gut. Denn ich möchte unbedingt wissen, wie es sich anfühlt, mal eine Frau zu sein.
Thank you.
Stop. I would like to tell you a story about sacrifice and how I lost my virginity. When I was a little girl, I always wanted to be a boy. I grew up among boys, so I wanted to be one of them. I wanted to be part of the gang of my brothers. They were tough. They were a bunch of tough boys. So in order to become one of them, they made me go through all kinds of initiation rites and tests. Like the night when I had to sacrifice a lamb. One summer we all went camping in the mountains in France near a farm. And I had to show them. I had to prove to them that I was also a boy. So they made me grab the axe and decapitate the lamb. And I really wanted to be a boy. So I went to pick up the lamb in the farmyard. I laid it upon the stone. I took the axe and I tried. I tried to be a man, but I could not finish the job. So I went back to bed. I left the dying animal crying. I kept hearing it cry the whole night long. The whole night long. I also always wanted to be a ballerina. To be on pointures, you know, Spitzenschuhe of Deutsch. These ballet shoes that makes you high and light, yeah. But I was too tall and I was too fat. And so at school, all the guys were falling for my pointures ballerina girlfriends, Alice, Clémence, Pauline, Caroline, Céline. But not for me. Guys don't fall for guys, right? And so when I wanted to lose my virginity, the guys always ran away. At the same time, Alice, Clémence, Pauline, Caroline, and Céline were becoming women. And I was still a guy, though I was craving dick. Eventually, I did not want to be that guy any longer, and my breasts made it impossible to be a guy anyway. I guess this is exactly what that guy thought one night as I woke up with his fingers inside my virginity. Thank you. Place. Ah. thought she should actually look at the sky. And he did to her as he walked.
I want to take a motorbike road trip across America.
I want to be rich and famous.
Thank you.
to make love with a woman.
I want to be a movie star. I want to save a life.
I want to be a hero. I want to be self-reliant in nature. I want to kill and grow and eat my own food. I want to take a sailboat and solo sail it across the Pacific Ocean and stop on all those little islands with all those little tribes. I want to build a house, my own house, and I want to have children, lots and lots of children. I want to be a muse for the most beautiful piece of art that you've ever seen, and it'll live past when I'm gone. And I want to shoot a gun, and I want to magically fly, and I want to make that kind of cake that when you put it on the plate and you put the fork in it,
I don't want to be alone.
If I had 2 months to live, I would be shit scared. You see, I grew up on this clear concept of heaven and hell, like in this Hieronymus Bosch drawings, where the upper part is a beautiful lake and a beautiful forest with bright colors, a bunch of naked bored people dipping their feet in the water. I don't know these people. I'm not going to the upper part of the drawing. I see myself grilled by a huge wild boar with the beautiful face of a singing bird standing on its rare legs with a flute coming up my ass. Or maybe I'd rather focus on this universal law that nothing ever ends. The amount of matter in this universe has always been the same and always will be. Every energy is borrowed while it's traveling the universe and must be returned. You see, every thought you'd have, every eye blink, every footstep you do will echo into this universe, travel through stardust and other planets till eternity. When I die, I will feed the earth that will feed the grass. The grass will feed the deer will feed the wolf, and so on and so on. And I'll keep on going my journey in all these beings. Or Maybe I'd rather focus on reincarnation, thinking that this life that ends is just one life out of endless amount of lives that I already had and will have. Which brings me to the thought of karma. One would think karma should make you feel doing good stuff in this life in order to come as a better creature in the next life. But karma also relieves you from guilt or from conscience, from the misery of other creatures. You see, all these cows and chickens that grow in small cages and have nothing in their life but misery and antibiotic injections, that's their karma. If they were better creatures in their life before, they wouldn't end up as a schnitzel on my plate. I think we keep on encountering the same people each life again and again and again. If in the next life I'll be a tree in the jungle, the worm in my bark will be my ex-girlfriend, the bird that nests in my shade will be my mother, the monkey on my branch, that's my housemaster. Somebody told me it's like a flat circle. We live this life, we die, and we start it all over again. Doing the same choices, making the same stupid mistakes, carrying the same scars, falling in love with the same people at the same moment, laughing at stupid jokes at the same time. We keep on living, dying, and doing it again and again and again. Which means that you will be here in front of me again and again and again, hearing my stupid theories about afterlife until eternity.
Thank you. to beat. And they lay me down to rest in some flowery bough retreat. Will you miss me? Will you miss me? Will you miss me? Will you miss me when I'm gone? Perhaps you'll plant me flower on my poor unworthy grave and come sit along beside me when the rose is not and weak. Will you miss me? Will you miss me? Will you miss me?
Ist gestern auch gefilmt worden?
Gestern wurde nicht gefilmt.
Ah, okay.
Schneidet dann das aus.